Hey guys, it's Kevin here from Formula Performance. This is an update, part two, First Love. Now, I lost the audio to this video, so I'm kind of just going over some of the video clips that I have. I apologize if it jumps around a little bit. Right now, we're looking at the rear of the Jeep. You can tell that we've welded on a rear bumper and completed some body work to the rear of the Jeep. In the front of the Jeep, more body work has been completed. And we're kind of just going over our game plan for the next few weeks of this particular build. We're going to take a closer look at some of the work right now on the hood, the front grille, and the bumper. Right now it's just been sanded. The passenger front fender needed a little bit of body fill for a small dent. We were fortunate the driver's side fender was in fairly good shape. And the hood overall is in very good shape for its age. No major dents, just needs a good sanding and some primer. Pretty typical front windshield frame gets some pitting and rust around the wiper arms. It's very common. The windshields have a tendency to rust out. I don't know if it's the seals or just the nature of the design of the Jeep, but they do seem to rot towards the bottom side of the windshield frame. On the passenger side, we're kind of going over some of the work that's been done. You can see that a little bit of body fill has been added to the windshield channel area of the passenger door. Again, a very typical spot for a Jeep to rust. On the bottom here, you can see that there's a hole in the passenger front fender. We're going to fill that. But this Jeep is going to get diamond plated rockers on both sides. Very little rust. These Jeeps spent most of their lives on the beach. If you are from Long Island, we're very fortunate that you can ride your Jeep on the beach and enjoy it, fishing, surfing, just out for a day trip, whatever the case may be. We're just getting a closer look. The hardtop has been sanded. We are going to paint this complete Jeep in one color. The color reveal for this Jeep is going to be a gloss black. We're going to do another $100 paint job on this particular Jeep. We're going to use a Rust-Oleum product. And we're going to thin it down with acetone. And we're going to apply it over the complete Jeep. It's going to have the body in gloss black, the top in gloss black, the frame in gloss black. It's going to come out phenomenal, guys. This video is from a few weeks ago. Very excited for you guys to see the new completed Jeep project when I bring out that video in the next couple of weeks. You can see that we were just doing a small patch of fiberglass on the driver's side floor. We started to clean up some of the wiring that the dash needed. And the passenger floor is in very good shape. No rot by the roll cage mounts on the floor. Again, another common area for Jeeps to rot out is around the roll cage area. This Jeep did not have any of those issues. We're going to put a full interior back in this Jeep with a rug and seats. And we're going to clean up the inside a little bit more. Now here on the driver's side, not a lot of rust, a small area under the Jeep emblem on the rocker. This side will get diamond plates on the rockers. It's a common upgrade. It's a little bit for protection. It's a nice look. Kind of breaks up the paint a little bit. This Jeep has a slight lift on it and oversized tires, so it kind of goes with that more of a off-road theme. Again, the rocker didn't really need that much work, just a little bit of body fill for a small pitting and a hole. And here's a look at the front driver's side fender. Again, just some brush cleanup. This Jeep will have to be primed before it gets painted. Guys, thanks for watching. I truly appreciate it.